Well, this is an interesting ration that I've been looking for quite a while, and I've managed to get one of these from MRE Mountain in the States. Wasn't cheap, but it's rare and it's worth it. This one is a food packet long range patrol from 1979 or 80, crossover period where they changed the colour of the bag from the dark brown to the tan colour. As you see, it's the beef hash menu number one, packed by the Seal Bag Company, Rochester, New York. It weighs about 300 grams. It's a very light ration compared to a modern freeze-dried ration, which weighs about 500 grams. And then compared to a regular retort pouch style meal, which weighs about 600, depending, you know, more or less 600, depending on what the entrees are. So let's get this one open and have a little look at the contents. I'll slip that open carefully from the back and I'll mark the front, but the packaging is still nice to look at in my collection. This is our accessory pack. Accessory packet, menu number one, cornflake bar orange, cocoa beverage, matches, coffee, creamer and sugar. Have this nice little touch as well, a bit of cardboard wrapped around it to stop anything pinpricking the contents in your pack or in storage in general. And MRE spoon, nice and solid. Tissue paper, it's gone kind of browny colour. Now, freeze dried entree beef hash. It still seems to be in a vacuum. So what I'm going to do first off, I'm going to open this up and put some hot water in it and let it soak while I'm going through what's in the pouch. Now it's got a tear notch there. Yep, a slight faint rush of air coming into that. Stick my nose in there. Okay. You know what an old radio receiver smells like? I mean, an old Bakelite radio that's got vacuum tubes in it, or valves. You stick your nose in the back of that and you smell all the burnt out wiring, all the old capacitors that are melted and stuff. And the smell of many years. Well, that's the smell that I'm getting from here. But the inner pouch itself is also... Well, it's not damp, it doesn't seem to be anything wrong with that. Can we focus on that? That's what it looks like in its dried form. Scrunch it up a bit. Another smell, yeah. Fish food. Keep carp, you know someone that keeps carp? Well, this is what the bag of feed smells like. But it also smells meaty and soupy. That's not bad at all. It doesn't smell terrible to me. So let's get some water with that and make a cup of tea while we're waiting, or coffee, depending on what's in the accessory pack. Oh, coffee, it said. Alright, I'd rather put too little water than too much. Now that, it smells just like normal, regular beef hash that you've opened from a tin. Now this spoon is okay. It's a little short. It's the sort you get your knuckles messy, which is probably why they put the longer spoons in with the MREs. Because people complained that they got messy knuckles. Yeah, that does smell very nice. It smells meaty. I can't smell anything strange about that at all. Don't think much of that spoon. I use a modern spoon, but let's leave that to hydrate. And have a little look in here. Now that's packed really, really tightly. There's no tear notch, but my fingers are now so greasy that I probably wouldn't be able to use it anyway. Okay, I do see a tear notch, let's try that. I couldn't hear any noise or anything. Air rushing into the vacuum pack. Oh, hang on, let's get a smell of that. Yeah, very strange. I can't even describe that. I can't describe that at all. So we've got some coffee instant type one. It actually feels solid, but it might not be. So we've got two of those. Cream substitute dry, that sort of hard and snappy. The sugar, everything seems to be kind of grease covered. Cocoa beverage, again, absolutely solid. I think that's where the smell's coming from. It's permeated the packaging, but I might be wrong. And this one is the fruit flavoured cornflake bar type 3. Well, I've opened the cream substitute. It didn't look that great. I'll show that in a moment. The sugar itself is absolutely perfect, dry, crystallised, it hasn't clumped up or anything. No damp got into that over the 40 odd years. 6 grams there, probably enough for two coffees, and you do get two sachets of the instant type one. And likewise with the coffee as well. This is what the coffee's gone like. Hard, brittle, still smells nice. It smells really nice. Got a kind of strong licorice-y flavour to it. So I'm going to have that black. Now I'm getting a lovely smell off that. A lovely smell indeed. Now that's dissolved perfectly. Very nicely. Wow, yeah, that's it. Forget what it looked like in the pouch. The flavour is all there. That is what I've waited for a long time. This is a coffee instant type 1, style 1, composition 2. It tastes beautiful, absolutely amazing. Mm. beautiful colour, beautiful flavour. That's quite interesting. You notice the early pouches packs have the strike on the front. The newer ones have the strike on the back. That doesn't tell you to close the cover before striking. Still made by D.D. Bean and Sons. These matches are designed especially for damp climates, but will not light when wet. Well, I don't think they've got wet. Let's close the cover. Well, there you go. 40-year-old matches. Still function. Well, let's have a little look at my entree now. The smell is absolutely gorgeous. There's nothing wrong with the way that smells. In fact, the taste, I mean, I've already licked the spoon a few times, so there's nothing wrong with the way it tasted. Yeah, that's how it looks. And the flavour, very nice, very beefy. Maybe a bit dry still. I could have put a little bit more water with that. Try a bit from the corner. Now, still not fully hydrated. Maybe they never did, even when they were new. But the flavour's beautiful, the consistency is amazing. And it's hydrated into a really nice portion as well. It's a bigger portion than you force into a retort pouch. You would never get that amount in a pouch unless it was a huge pouch. And then it would also put up the weight of the ration that you'd be expected to carry around. Lovely. Absolutely lovely. Nothing wrong with that at all. I'll finish that in a while. Let's try the paper, see if the paper still absorbs. Now this one comes from Travel Paper Company, Green Bay, Wisconsin. Kind of dirty brown colour. Later rations, they actually coloured them blue. Maybe the dirty brown colour was a bit off-putting. But it's actually toilet tissue that's in small sized pieces. It's not a very absorbent type, it's a bit slimy, but it's only tissue. So this is what we want to see now. We want to see this. Cornflakes, syrup, something. Sugar-coated, hydrogenated, short something. Shortening. Egg. Okay. Let's open her up. That's what it looks like. I can focus on that. There you go. Let me snap it. Oh, it snaps like a shortbread biscuit. It smells like that orange stuff that you clean bicycles with. The flavour. Um, doesn't smell bad. It doesn't smell fresh. It doesn't taste, I dare say, like it did when it was new, but then maybe. It's a very slight bitterness to it, but it's orangey, cornflakey. Yeah, it's okay. But I'm sure it tasted fresher a few decades ago. And I have this to try at a later date. Just have a quick look at the cream substitute. Doesn't quite look right, does it? Just have a little bite of that. Yeah, that's not the best I've tasted. I would not use that. But the rest of it, considering it's 40 years old, is great. Well, I decided it wouldn't be fair to review this cocoa beverage separately. It would be totally out of context. So I'm going to review this one with the rest of the 40-year-old MRE. Now, it does feel very solid inside, but that's not to say it might not dissolve. So the aluminized pouch, so I shouldn't have opened it like that, never mind. It's also got plastic inside it. Now it's turned into this sort of texture. It's still got that weird background taste to it as well. And smell. Yeah, an old exploded radio set. Bakelite radio. Also the powdered milk. That's what came back in with a bit of vengeance, the small piece I put on my tongue. Decided that it wanted to turn to soap after about a minute. I couldn't wash that nasty flavour out of my mouth. Yeah, now you would imagine that this was pretty well sealed with a little plastic pouch on the inside and the foil to keep the light out of it. But there's our texture. Pretty hard, solid. Same strange exploded smell, but not totally unpleasant. And didn't leave a soapy flavour in my mouth. Now, as this is dissolving, it's not dissolving properly, it's just turning into little bits. Now, I have seen one or two of these old rations reviewed on YouTube. And the cocoa's look better than this. But it's almost dissolved there. I'll leave that for a bit longer. Okay, it's been dissolved in there for a short while. Now, can you see how that's gone? It's gone like a broth. All the little bits, particles are in the suspension, but not 100% dissolved into the water. And it's got that strange kind of exploded radio and soap smell to it. Oh, in fact, yeah, with the steam, it is really not pleasant at all. The flavour just tastes like chocolate, dark chocolate. And then you inhale. Best not to inhale. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, don't inhale. Just, it tastes like chocolate. It's sweet, chocolatey. You can't taste all the little bits in it. Well, I wouldn't say it was particularly unpleasant. It's not something I would look forward to in a ration. But it's, you know, past its best, obviously. 40 odd years ago, when this was packed by the DMP Corporation in Mobile, Alabama, it probably tasted very, very nice back then, the year I left school. Yeah, I can't afford to tip this away. I spent a lot of money on this ration. Was it worth it? Oh, yes, absolutely. Yeah, I've had the privilege of being able to taste one of these and review it and let everyone else know how great I found it, or not, as the case may be. I don't know if this will make me ill or not. Yeah, I think it probably would if I finished that, which is a shame. I'm going to say I'm not going to finish this. I'm going to tip it away. It's the soapiness has got me worried. Well, not worried, but it's put me off finishing the whole cup. But there you go. Got this one from MRE Mountain. Cost a lot of money to have it shipped to the UK. You might be able to pick them up at a better price in the States. You might even do you free shipping, but don't quote me on that. But yes, the only problem with the entire ration was just the cocoa beverage powder and that soapy milk. But yeah, I would say that's worth every penny.